सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट। प्रोफेसर डॉक्टर मनोज कुमार टुडे डिस्कस एंड गिव लेक्चर ऑन द सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट। सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट द कंटेंट्स ऑफ हिज लेक्चर विल बी देयर अबाउट द ट्यूटोरियल्स ऑडियंस प्रीरिक्विजिट टेबल ऑफ द कंटेंट्स। सेल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट इंट्रोडक्शन। स्किल्स ऑफ ए सेल्स एग्जीक्यूटिव। व्हाट आर द स्किल्स ऑफ द सेल एग्जीक्यूटिव विच इज नेसेसरी टू गेट। इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट। ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट। व्हाट आर द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट आर देयर। व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट आर देयर। सेल्स एंड डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट। सेल्स मैनेजमेंट स्टेप्स। व्हाट आर द सेल्स मैनेजमेंट स्टेप्स। व्हाट आर द सेट ऑब्जेक्टिव। व्हाट आर द डेवलप सेल्स स्ट्रेटजी। व्हाट आर द डेवलप टैक्टिक्स। सेल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस। व्हाट इज द सेल्स डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मैनेजमेंट प्रोसेस। व्हाट इज द प्लानिंग। व्हाट इज द स्टाफिंग। व्हाट इज द ट्रेनिंग। व्हाट इज द लीडिंग। व्हाट इज द कंट्रोलिंग एंड व्हाट इज द परफॉर्मेंस। What is the planning for that? You have to make a plan for the sales, that the where the sales can be done. Staffing is to be done for that. Staff must to be remain better. Training for the sales is to be done. Leading is done. Controlling is done. Performance is done. Then the SDM sales method, electronic sales. What are the sales distribution methods at the request for the proposal is there. SDM techniques for the sale. Conceptual selling. Sales negotiation. Sales negotiation strategy. What are the negotiation strategy for the sales will be there. Negotiation outcomes will be there. Reverse selling will be there. Takeaway is there. Sales outsourcing is there. What are the advantages of the sales outsourcing? What are the advantages of the sales outsourcing? You have to know about the what are the advantage of the sales organization. SDM sales organization. Characteristics of the sales organization is there. What are the characteristics of a sales organization? What is the significance of a sales organization? Different type of the sales organization. Functional type, product type, consumer special type, area type. What are the types of the sales organization you will study here? What are the sales quota? What are the objectives of the sales quota is there? What are the types of the sales quota is there? What are the methods for the setting sales quota? Methods for the setting the sales quota. Sales distribution mission is sales territory. Region for establishing territory. Procedure for the designing of the territory. Select control point. Making an account analysis. Developing a salesperson workload analysis. Combining geographical control unit into the sales territory. Territory shape. Assigning sales personnel to territory. Assigning sales personnel to territory. SDM, personal selling. Objective of the personal selling. Relevant situation for the personal selling, diversity of the selling situation. What are the objectives of the personal selling is there? What are the relevant situation for the personal selling is there? What are the diversity of the selling situation is there? Sales distribution management steps in the personal selling. What are the steps in the personal selling? Prospecting. Train, educate the prospects. Preparation for the sale of the product. What are the preparation for the sale of the product? Presentation, handling objection, closing the sale, follow-up. Steps in the personal selling. SDM, sales management budget. Objective of the sales budgeting. Methods of the sales budgeting. Preparation of the sales budget. Communicating overall objective. Selling the sales budget to the top management. selling the sales budget to the top management. Then the sales distribution management, marketing channel, wholesale, retail. Wholesale and the retail. So you have a study about the different perspectives of the sales and distribution management. Sales and distribution management and introduction. Sales refers to the exchange of goods, commodity against money or the service. And exchange of the goods or commodity against money or service. It is the only revenue generative function in an organization. You will gain the money in the exchange of the service, in the exchange of the good, in the exchange of the commodity. It is the only revenue generative function in an organization. It is a only revenue generative function in an organization. It has formed an important part in the business throughout history. Even prior to the introduction of the money, people used to exchange goods in order to fulfill the needs. Even prior to the introduction of the money, people used to exchange goods in order to fulfill the needs, which is known as the barter system. Barter system. Example of a barter system, A has a 100 kg of the rice, B has a 50 kg of the wheat, where A needs wheat and B needs rice. They agree to exchange 50 kg of the rice and 20 kg of the wheat upon mutual understanding. This is the barter system. Condition of the sales. There are two parties involved in the transaction, the seller and the buyer. The seller is the provider of the goods or services and the buyer is the purchaser in the exchange of the money. The seller is the provider of the goods or services and the buyer is the purchaser in the exchange of the money. The seller of the goods has to transfer the title of the ownership of the item to the buyer upon an agreed price. A person who sells goods or services on behalf of the seller is known as the salesman woman. Distribution is the process of making a product or service available for use or consumption to the end consumer or the business. Distribution could be of the following types. Direct distribution, indirect distribution. Direct distribution, it can be defined as expanding or moving from one place to the another without changing direction or stopping. For example, Bata has no distribution channel. It sells its products directly to the end consumer. This is the direct distribution system. Bata has no distribution channel. It sells its product directly to the end consumer. Indirect distribution, it can be defined as means that are not directly caused or the resulting from the something. For example, LG sells its product from the factory to the dealers and it reaches the consumer through the dealers. This is the indirect distribution. The following image shows the end product stored at a warehouse ready for shipment to the dealer and consumers. Sales management in an organization is a business discipline which focuses on the practical application of the sales technique and the management of the firm's sales operation. It is done in an efficient and effective manner through planning, staffing, training, leading, and controlling organizational resources. Sales management is done by sales manager and they are responsible for generating sales, profits, and the customer satisfaction. For generating sales profit and the customer satisfaction. Skills of a sales activity. Sales management is an art where the sales executive or the salesperson helps the organization or individual to achieve its objective or buy a product with their skills. The following are some skills that a sales executive need to process. Conceptual skills. Conceptual skill includes the formation of the idea, manager, understand, abstract relationship, improve ideas, and solve issue creativity. The sales executive should be very well versed with the concept of the product he is selling. People skills involve the ability to interact effectively with people in a friendly way, especially in business. The term people skill involves both psychological skills and the social skills, but they are less inclusive than the life skills. Every person has a different mindset, so a sales executive should know how to present the product depending on the customer's mindset. Technical skills are the ability to capture through the learning and the practice. They are often job or task specific. In simple words, a specific skill set or proficiency is required to perform a specific job or task. As a part of the conceptual skills, a sales executive should also have a good grasp on the technical skills of the product. Decision skills are the most important because of the tackle the questions from the consumer. Sales executive should always have the knowledge of the competitor's product and take a wise decision. Monitoring performance. Sales executive should monitor the performance of the employee and report to the higher management to improve the performance and fill the loopholes. This is the monitoring the performance of the employee and report to the higher management to improve the performance and fill the loopholes. Thus, conceptual skills deal with the idea, technical skills deal with the things, people skill concerns, individual technical skills are concerned with the product specific skills, and the decision skill related to the decision making. This is the monitoring performance. Importance of the sales management. Sales management is very, very crucial for many organizations to achieve its target. In order to increase the customer demand a particular product, we need management of the sales. The following point needs to be considered for the sales management in an organization. The first and foremost importance of the sales management is that it facilitates the sale of a product at a price, which realizes profit and helps in generating revenue to the company. It helps to achieve organizational goals and objective by focusing on the aim and planning a strategy regarding the achievement of the goal within a time frame. Sales team monitor the customer preference, government policy, computer situation, etc. to make the required changes accordingly and manage the sales. By monitoring the customer preference, the salesperson develops a positive relationship with the customer, which helps to retain the customer for a long period of the time. And customer relationship is there. You have to be monitoring the customer preference, which helps to retain the customer for a long period of the time. Both the buyers and seller have the same type of the relationship, which is based on the exchange of the good, service and money. This helps in attaining customer satisfaction. Sales management may differ from one organization to the other, but overall, we can conclude that sales management is very important for organization for achieving its short and long-term goals. Objective of the sales management. Every organization has an objective before initializing functions. We need to understand the goal of the managing sales. Here, we are discussing sales management in terms of its objective. Sales volume. It is the capacity or the number of items sold or services sold in the normal operation of a company in a specified period. The foremost objective of sales management is to increase sales volume to generate revenue. Increase the sales value to generate the revenue. How the revenue can be generated? Increase the sales volume. Contribution to the profit. The sales of the organization should contribute to the profit as it is the only revenue generating department. It can be calculated as the passenger or ratio of gain in the total turnover. Contribution to the profit. The sales of the organization should contribute to the profit as it is the only revenue generating department. It can be calculated as the percentage or ratio of gain in the total turnover. Continuing growth. One of the main objectives of the sales management is to retain consumers to continue growth of the organization. There should be regular expansion of the sales and demand for an item in the market with new advanced formulation. There are the major objectives a sales executive has to focus on in sales management. SDM, sales management steps. Company use sales strategy and tactics in order to make a consumer buy their product or services. Before we processed further, we should know the meaning of the sales strategy and the tactics. Although they go hand in hand, they are distinct. Set objective. The very first step in the sales management is the setting goals and the objective. The senior management of a firm needs to sit together and reach a mutual decision regarding what is the vision and resolution of the firm is. This may be sound quite easy, but setting objective as a framework for designing a company. If efficient decisions are made and objectives are set according to the company's potential and the market demand, the company progresses wonderfully. However, if the objectives are poorly set, then the company might not prosper. Set objective. Develop a strategy as per set objective. Develop the tactics. Develop set strategy. After the objectives are set for the company to achieve, a strategy needs to be designed. Sales strategy can be defined as how a company markets or wants to sell its product or the services. It can be a concept of how the company meets the desired objectives and the marketing goals. It also clarifies what the sales executives do. Strategy includes various components. Following are the components. Knowledge of the company's brand history and the consumer market. Company's brand history is the important, and the consumer market knowing is important. The way marketing is going to influence the overall business. Competitors' performance. Pros and cons of the plan. Develop the tactics. A strategy explains the purpose of the company, whereas tactics explain the process to move forward and implement the plan. Sales strategy is important as compared to the individual tactics, but after the strategy is designed, we need to develop tactics to follow the strategy. Sales tactic can be defined as the action taken by the company to impose its sales strategy to bring it to life. There are different modes in which the company delivers the message to the consumers, such as a website, brochures, advertisement in the social media, etc. These are the sales tactics. Sales tactics can be defined as the action taken by the company to impose its sales strategy to bring it to life. There are different modes in which the company delivers the message to the consumer, such as a website, brochures, advertisement in the social media, etc. An investor or lender will invest in the company if they know about the objective and the strategy of the company. Else, it becomes difficult for the company and the lenders to make or justify a decision of whether to invest in the company. The company has to know that investment by lender is very much required for the marketing campaign. If the tactics are excellent, but the strategies are not defined in a proper manner, or the defined poorly, it does not help the company to grow. Sales distribution management process. Sales management in an organization is a business discipline which focuses on the practical application of the sales technique and the management of a firm's sales operation. It is done in an efficient manner through planning, staffing, training, leading, controlling, and organizational resources. Now we will explain each of these processes. Planning. Planning can be defined as the process of the decision making in a systematic manner regarding the goals and the objective of an organization. In short, it is a process an individual or group will undertake in the future and the resources required for attaining them. Sales planning includes strategy, setting profit-based sales target, quota, sales forecasting, demand management, and the screening, writing, and execution of a sales plan. A sales plan is a strategic document that outlines the business target, resources, and the sales activity. It basically follows the lead of the marketing plan, the strategy plan, and the business plan with more precise detailing on how the goals and objective can be achieved through the actual sale of the product and the services. Staffing. Staffing is the process of capturing, deploying, and retaining a workforce of the optimal quantity and the quality to create a positive impact on the firm's effectiveness. And capturing, deploying, and retaining a workforce of the optimal quantity and quality to create a positive impact on the firm's effectiveness. There must be the optimal quantity, no more quantity and no less quantity, and the quality to create the impact on them. Staffing consists of the following three components. Acquisition. It involves human resource planning to select what the organization requires in terms of the number of employees needed and their attributes such as knowledge, skills, and ability in order to effectively meet job requirement. Deployment. It includes decision regarding how those recruited will be assigned to a specific role according to the business demand. It also concerns the frequent appointment to move more advanced job through the internal recruitment, promotion, or the reorganization. Retention, it is concerned with the management of the outflow of the employee from an organization. It combines both managing voluntary practices like the resignation and the controlling involuntary measures whereby employees are handled out of the organization through redundancy program or other types of the dismissal. Deployment, it includes decision through the regarding how those recruited will be assigned to a specific roles according to the business demand. It also concerns the frequent appointment to the more advanced job through the internal recruitment, promotion, and the reorganization. Staffing is basically used in the sphere of the employment. It is applicable to more than one aspect of the working surrounding. Staffing is also used in a specific sense to refer to the management of the employee schedule. Training. The training program in the sales management provides frontline sales manager with the proven skills, knowledge, and tools that need to drive margin line performance. Training program is essential in the sales management for the frontline sales manager. This in-depth the program involves self-assessment and covers the following four crucial sales management ability: managing sales performance, sales coaching, recruiting, selecting sales stars, sales leadership. After the sales personnel are recruited, the company ensures the training of job and on-job training related to the skills, knowledge, and job culture, which helps to meet the selling performance of the goal. Leading is done by the person who possesses the leadership quality, the ability to motivate other people and get the work done. Leading is an executive, effective sales management force that invites the sales management executive to use practical tools and the cutting edge concept to create an effective sales management model. This model is derived after a thorough research and consulting experience through cases, group discussion, problem solving exercise, computer aided workshop, and the communication skills presentation. The managers need to explore various perspectives on what does and does not work and why. A leader also monitors the work and explains the pros and cons as well as the ways to complete a task effectively and efficiently. Controlling. The task assigned to the sales personnel is monitored to find out whether the organization is achieving its target or goals as per the planning. Controlling is a process which defines the scope of the leads and actual performance against the planned goals of the organization. Controlling dwells in verifying whether everything happens in the conformity with the planned adapted instruction issued and the principal authorized. Controlling assures that there is effective and efficient utilization of the organizational resources so as to achieve the planned goals and the objective. Controlling the judges. The deviation of the actual performance from the standard performance notices the causes of the such deviation and helps in taking the correct action. The following figure depicts sales management with its function and explains the role of each function. All the roles are interrelated and individual function cannot relate to work without the help from the other. Planning, budgeting a profitable oriented customer, resources, human resources, financial resources, raw material resources, technology resources, information resources. Consulting, assess based on the past performance for the improvement. Leading, monitoring people to the improve skills. Staffing, hiring right people for the right work. Training sales personnel to the achieve goals. Performance, achieve goals, generate profit, customer satisfaction, efficiency, and the effectiveness. Performance in the, how the goals of the company have been achieved. How the generate profit, how to generate the profit is the main function performance of the sales management. How the customer satisfaction is there. How the customer satisfaction is there, how the efficiency is there, how the effectiveness is there. This is the performance management. Achieving the goals, generating the profit, customer satisfaction, efficiency, effectiveness, how it can be achieved. Resources. Resources are one of the important parts of the sales management, as without resources, the plant process cannot be improved. Resources include the following. Human resources. Human resources can be defined as that section of the business organization that deals with the hiring, administration, and training of staff. In sales management, we can say it is the salesperson responsible for selling, marketing of the product or the services. Financial resources is the capital available to a business for investing in the form of the cash, liquid security, and the credit line. It is the capital available to the business for investing in the form of the cash, land security, and the credit line. Before going into business, a businessman needs to secure sufficient financial resources. This is required in order to able to function efficiently and sufficiently well to promote success. It includes the finance that the company needs to perform the activity like campaign and the advertisement. It includes the finance that company needs to perform the activity like campaign and the advertisement. Materials, they are assets in the form of the material possessions. Here by the assets, we mean everything of the material value or usefulness that is owned by individual or a company. It includes the source from where the raw material could be produced in the low cost. Technology. It is the application of the science, especially to the industrial or commercial goal and the objective. It also includes the scientific technique and material used to achieve a commercial or industrial objective, as well as the machinery and the techniques that the organization uses for the end product. It will now be clear why resources are important in managing the sales. Performance. Performance is the completion of a given task measured against the non-preset standard of the accuracy. Completeness, cost, and speed. In a contract, performance is assumed to be the fulfillment of the accountability in a manner that releases the performer from all liability under the contract. The last function is to review the performance. In this function, the leader reviews the past performance and advises the sales personnel regarding the improvement required. It also involves checking that all the functions are working in a proper way and there is no deviation in achieving the goal. SDM sales method. Sales method can be explained as one of the several techniques used to recognize revenue, especially when revenue and expense are recognized at the time of the case collection rather than at the time of the sale. Thus, we can say that the sales method are the different ways to sell the product or the services. The sales personnel help to sell the end product to the consumer. Some sales methods are the given below. Direct sales. Direct sale is the sale of the goods, services involving personal contact. This is the direct sale. It can be defined as the most important method that is used as most of the consumers prefer to purchase the goods through a direct contact with the seller, during which they understand the features and get to know about the needs and the benefits. The above illustration depicts the seller in the middle as buyers are seen reaching out to the seller. It is an example of the direct sale where the buyers are approaching the seller in an orange. Boeing Airlines sells it the air basis directly to the consumer with no intermediary involved. Boeing Airlines, directly to the consumers. Pro forma sales, the term pro forma is a Latin word which means as a matter of a form or the sake of the form. It is commonly used to describe a practice or document that is provided as a courtesy and that satisfied limited requirement conforms to a norm of the doctrine, tends to be the performed pre-functionally and is considered a formality. Pro forma financial statement are fashioned to reflect a proposed change like a merger or acquisition or to emphasize certain figures when a company issues an earning announcement to the public. It can be termed as the practice or document that is provided as a courtesy or satisfy the minimum requirement which contain the details of the buyer and the receiver. It can also be termed as an invoice of the product. Agency-based sale. In agency-based sale, the organization hires an agent on contract basis. That sales agent acquires the right to negotiate the sale of the organization's goods or services in exchange of the field commission or fee. The commission is calculated on the basis of the percentage of the sales generated. Insurance policy, opening of the bank account, etc. Door-to-door. In door-to-door sales, the sales executive walks from the door of the one house to another sell product or services. For this type of the sales agent should be versatile and capable of quickly creating a relationship with the customer. Door-to-door sales. In door-to-door sales, the sales executive walks from the door of one house to the another sell the product or services. For this type of the sales agent should be versatile and capable of quickly creating a relationship with the customer. The following are some major duties of the sales personnel for door-to-door sales. Striking a conversation with the stranger, getting the form filled and completing the administrative task, getting the payments processed from the customer, building rapport with the customer, providing training to the new team member. These are some of the major responsibility that a door-to-door sales executive needs to be managed in order to maintain or increase productivity. Hawking. Hawking is associated with the hawker or the seller who sells the goods that can be easily transported. A hawker sells not too so expensive good on the street by shouting in the loud voice and chittering with the passers by who were to develop rapport and convince them to buy his goods. Hawking. In the above figure, we can see hawkers selling products on the roadside. In India, there are 10 million street vendors, Mumbai members in Mumbai and Delhi, contributing to the most of the number. Many consumers also preferred street shopping because of the low price of the product. B2B selling is known as the business-to-business selling. It refers to the situation where one business makes a transaction with the another. B2B occurs where factory products, goods, and sells them to the wholesaler. Example, food product manufacturer, shoes, and the bags. This is known as the B2B selling. Organization outsources its process to the other company to reduce the labor cost. Example, BPO, business process outsourcing. Company purchase raw material from another company to make the final product. Tata Steel purchase goods from its ancillary company. Electronic sales or the e-commerce is known as the trading of the goods or services through the internet. The figure given below depicts how e-commerce works. We can conclude that the e-commerce business has been increasing day by day due to easy access and the simplicity through the internet. Now, the trading of the goods or services through the internet. The figure given below depicts the e-commerce works, we can conclude that the e-commerce business has been increasing day to day by easy to access simplicity. The e-commerce business may imply some or all of the following: online shopping website or retail sales direct to consumers, providing or participating in online marketplace which process third party business to consumer or consumer to consumer sales, business to business buying and the selling, gathering and utilizing demographic data through web contacts or the social media, marketing to prospective and established customer by the email or the fax with the newsletter, engaging in prevailing market for launching new products and the services. Thus, e-commerce can be defined as the business conducted through the application of the computers, telephones, fax machine, barcode readers, credit cards, automatic teller machine, ATM, or other electronic appliances, whether or not using the internet without the exchange of the paper-based document. Request for the proposal. Request for proposal is a type of the bidding procedure by a company who is interested in the procurement of the goods or services from potential supplier to submit business proposal. Given below are the salient features of a request for the proposal. It informs the supplier that a company is looking to solicit and inspire them to make their best effort. The company has to provide sales specification regarding the proposal to purchase and if the analysis regarding the requirement is prepared. Accordingly, it can be easily integrated into the request document. It also signals suppliers that the selection process is the competitive. It ensures that the supplier responds factually to the identified requirement. The selection process is structured so that there is partially in the process. Thus, a request for the proposal is a proposal that a company ensures for procurement of the product. The above points enlist the function of a general request for the proposal used by the company. SDM techniques of the sale. Sales technique are techniques for selling a product or service for marketing success. In layman terms, it is a combination of talking to the right people and finding out what they actually want to buy. It depends on the consumer choice and the preference. A salesperson using sales technique does not just sell the product. In fact, he looks at the customer's need or want them, then offers the product after explaining its advantage and disadvantage. This helps the customer to differentiate among the available products, making the decision easy for the customer. This way of selling is more impressive than the sampling delivery of the product. It also helps to build a rapport between the customer and the salesperson who understand how much the product is worth to the customer. Conceptual selling. Conceptual selling is a type of the sales technique which requires the salesperson to the first understand their customer's issue, what they are trying to accomplish, fix or avoid. Then the salesperson applies his expertise to find a solution for the customer. By applying this approach, it helps to build trust with the customer and the solution found become difficult for the competitors to the duplicate. Conceptual selling is like introducing a new methodology, a revolutionary delivery method, a different way of serving customer and finding a new way to resolve old problems. Conceptual selling is classified into the following four categories: perceptual, change, emotional, and fundamental need. Conceptual selling, perceptual change, emotional, and the fundamental need. Perceptual, perception is the way a person looks at the something. It differs from person to person, and it is also possible for the perception of the two people to be alike. This psychological proposal asks the consumer to change the attitude toward the something or view it in a different way from the existing point of the view. In other words, the seller requests the buyer to view things from a different perspective. Change is vital, and the thing cannot be the same for a long period of the time. The first step itself relates to the change. Most of the time, the first step is the conceptual selling. The buyer should be interested in listening to new ideas and seriously apply himself to something different. Emotional. While the seller describes the product to the consumer, He wants an emotional relation with the consumer. The seller should be a passionate and eager. It plays a major role in the selling. This helps to increase credibility with the consumer and also helps to retain the consumer for a long period of the time. Fundamentally, the fundamental need of a product satisfies a conceptual sale. The assumption is that the product serves as a catalyst for the change that the seller petitions. In case the consumer does not understand that this fundamental need, he will not buy the product. Sales negotiation. Sales negotiation refers to the mutual discussion between the buyer and the seller for a transaction or the agreement. The negotiation can be a formal event at a specific date and the time. It can also be an ongoing process at a different point in the sales process. Why does a salesperson negotiate? The answer is because of a customer attitude toward the product or service. A customer attitude can be categorized in the four category. Objection. In this category, the customer shows an opposition to the product or the service. The customer is not satisfied with the product and opposes and raises a query against the product. Indifference. The customer is not interested or shows less interest in the product. The reason should be not perceived needs for its benefits. Skepticism. The customer has the perception of the product and its benefit, but it's in a dilemma if the product offer can really provide any benefit. Acceptance. In this category, the customer agrees with the benefit as advised by the salesperson and has no objection or the negative feedback towards the product. Thus, we can conclude that negotiation skills are required to change a customer's perception toward a product or the service. Customer's attitude, objection, indifference, skepticism, and acceptance. Sales negotiation strategy. A salesperson needs to practice some negotiation strategy to deal with the customers. The best way is to draw them into a problem-solving partnership. This initial step is to focus on the issue where the salesperson and the customer have the most agreement. The salesperson has to take a steep position initially so that when the compromise, the customer feels that he negotiated a bargain. The motive should be to concentrate on the solving the issue that satisfies the needs of both the buyer and the seller. Solution of the issue should be certain for both the parties to work on. It is very important to keep a record of the issue resolved in the process of the discussion and to request recaps to confirm the progress being made. This helps to roll up the discussion and easily arrive at the final conclusion. Negotiation outcome. The following are the four types of the negotiation outcome. Seller win, buyer win. In this outcome, there is a win-win situation for both the buyer and the seller. This is the important win-win situation for both the buyer and the seller. Out of the four, this is the only outcome that leads to the long-term success for both the party. This is the only outcome that leads to the long-term success for both the party. Seller win, buyer lose. In this case, the seller wins, but the buyer loses. If the customer is not satisfied, the business relationship is in trouble, as it may affect the reputation of the company. If the customer feels that he is not satisfied or he has not manipulated regarding the product description, he may refuse to have the something. If this is nature is aggressive, he may take action against the salesperson. Seller lose, buyer win. The buyer win in this negotiation and the salesperson will feel shortchanged and try to avoid the situation or even future negotiation. In this outcome also, the buyer and seller relationship is in trouble. Seller lose or the buyer lose. Both the buyer and seller lose are dissatisfied. After this outcome, it is very unlikely in future to have a negotiation between the two parties. Reverse selling. Reverse selling referred to a situation where the buyers get a chance to respond to the sales negotiation or feedback regarding the product or service. If you observe keenly, in most of the cases, the seller talks too much and is always ready to the question. Reverse selling is just the opposite. The buyers have to provide the feedback, which helps to develop a long-term relationship between the buyer and the seller. By this, the company can understand the pros and cons of its products and services, which helps to improvise and make changes accordingly. The traditional way of selling a product used by the salesperson is that he or she pressurizes the prospective buyer. Questioning strategy. Once the company has listed all the points and the required information, they need to prepare a questionnaire. The question should begin with the broad issue and should allow the buyer to express his or her point of the view. Engaging the buyer. Question can be open-ended or the closed-ended. If the questions are closed-ended, the buyer will not be able to apply his own perception or the point. An open-ended question gives the buyer a chance to explain an issue or to provide a proper feedback, whether positive or the negative. Reverse question. When a buyer evaluates a product, whether to purchase or otherwise, it gives an opportunity to the seller to pitch in the reconfirm the perception of the buyer. It helps to improve the relationship. The seller can better understand how to deal with the situation and what can be offered to the buyer to satisfy his or her needs. We can thus conclude that the reverse selling has now become an important part in today's competitive market. Takeaway selling technique have become very famous in the recent time. As the name suggests, in this type, the buyer takes the product and moves on. In the traditional system, the regular and takeaway counter used to be the same and people had to wait for a long event to take a small parcel. In the following illustration, we can see a modern takeaway counter where the buyer can easily grab a parcel and move on. Such takeaway counters help the buyer to get the product in less time. Takeaway. In few places, we have a takeaway counter where the customer orders the product from one side and the delivery is made on the other side of the road. This also saves a lot of time from the buyer. And this is the example of a takeaway. And we have a takeaway counter where the customer orders the product from one side and the delivery is made on the other side of the road. This also saves a lot of time for the buyer. Sales outsourcing. Sales outsourcing is a way by which one company outsources its process or part of the process to the other company. The company outsources its work to increase the sales volume without link to the sales team that carries on the sales campaign. The company that undertakes the process will be paid on a contract basis or as per the mutual understanding between both the party. The other party is accountable and answerable regarding all sales activity while representing the brand to the client. That party is responsible for all the operation associated with the direct sales activity. The main purpose of the sales outsourcing is to reduce the cost of the production. For example, in London, the labor cost is high as compared to India. So the company would like to outsource the process to India and get the work done in less cost as compared to the home country. This is the outsourcing advantage of the sales outsourcing. Sales outsourcing is cheaper as compared to the fully loaded cost of the employing sales personnel. The advantage of the sales outsourcing is increasing the revenue for the company by providing the same process in a different way by a third party. The company may also select outsourcing as a means to assess the best sales skill. From the company's point of view, if the work gets done in half of the cost as compared to the previous method, it will be obviously outsourced. Another reason of the outsourcing relates to a company that wants to set up its market in a new place. It would rather provide the contract to a local agency because they will understand the need and perception of that locality. This helps the company to easily set up the business and capture the market faster. SDM, sales organization. Sales organization is a department in company within logistics that designs the company as per the sales requirement. Sales organization is held responsible for the sales and distribution of goods and the services. The selling unit is represented as a legal unit. The salesperson plays a crucial role in the sales company because he is answerable for many activity in the company. Some of these activity can be listed below. Setting selling and the profit objective. The salesperson is involved in setting the objective of selling and product and generating the profit. Marketing policy. The salesperson has to set the marketing policy and the plan accordingly. Designing personal selling strategy. They also help to set up their own strategy to generate sales and to target and retain the customer. They coordinate with the other department as well. For example, advertising, sales promotion, and distribution to check out a sales program, which helps in generating sales. It also helps to find out any loopholes and fix the issue. Characteristics of a sales organization. Let us now understand the characteristics of the sales organization. A sales organization subsists of a group of the people who handle different activity like distribution, advertising, selling, etc. In order to achieve the sales objective, like increasing sales volume and maximizing profit and market share of the company. It specifies the responsibility and duty of the salesperson and also coordinates their activity with the other department. It helps to develop a relationship with the other personnel in the organization by setting up a sales program. General sales manager is the head of the sales organization. Thus, sales organization helps the company in achieving the target and building coordination with the sales personnel. Now we shall see the importance of the sales organization. Significance of the sales organization. Let us now understand the significance of the sales organization. To plan purchase, the sales of the company depend on the sales anticipation. The sales will increase only when the consumer purchases the goods or the services. Therefore, the company has to plan the sales according to the consumer need and want, meaning where they want the product, what they want, etc. The planning and development is done accordingly to satisfy the need of the customer. To create pattern of the demand or the product, the demand of the product is created to lead to sale in the market when a product is manufactured in the factory. It is not sold automatically. Salesperson pushes the product to the consumer, but even they cannot force the consumer to buy the product. The sale depends on the consumer's need and perception. This need is created by the selling skills promotion through the advertisement, which in turn help in creating demand in the market. To handle the orders received, this is an important step where the salesperson has to answer the calls and queries of the customer, receive order, and make the product ready as per the demand of the consumer. Finally, the products are packed and dispatched as per the expectation of the customer. All these are imperative and effective tasks. To collect the due, sales cannot always be done for the cash. Bulk sales are made on the credit. It is very difficult for an organization to perform only on the basis of the cash sales. In this competitive market, credit sales played a crucial role. After the credit sales have been done, the organization has to collect due. It is a very challenging task as the salesperson has to retain the business and still get the task done. To handle the task of the personnel management, every organization wants best sales personnel to enhance the sales. This depends on the training. The organization has to select, train, motivate, monitor, and control its sales personnel. Here, the company has to make an investment in the sales personnel. In summary, we can conclude that there is an immense impact of the sales organization on a company. Types of the sales organization. An organization is designed in a manner where we can identify the work or activity performed by an individual or group. The roles and responsibility are defined, which helps in building relationship to enable people do work effectively and efficiently. This helps in achieving the goals of the organization. The following are the four types of the sales organization. Functional type. Functional type of the organization is divided and classified on the basis of the function performed. The following illustration shows a functional type of the organization. Sales manager, advertising manager, personal selling manager, sales force manager, market research manager, promotion, and the PR manager. There are different type of the manager is there. Advertising manager, personal selling manager, sales force manager, market research manager, promotion, and the PR manager. These depict the functional type organization. We will now discuss the advantages and disadvantages of this type. Advantages of the functional type. The following are the advantages of the functional type organization. specialization in the figure, we can see the division has been made according to the function. By this, we can expect each function is specialized in its activity. Flexibility, the number of departments can be added or removed as per the requirement. Decision making, decision can be made quickly as the person would be an expert in his department and will be aware of the impact of his decision. Coordination, the coordination between function can be done easily. Disadvantage of the functional type. Let us now understand the disadvantage associated with the functional type of the organization. Due attention. Each department is only specialized in their one activity, hence there is no attention focused on the product. Delay. There is a delay in making decision because of the coordination between all the departments. Coordination, from the figure, we can see that all departments report to the general manager. Therefore, in peak times, it may become difficult for the general manager to maintain coordination between the department. Conflicts. There is always conflict between the departments due to being specialized only in one core area and the lack of the cross-training is there. In general, functional type of the organization is suitable where the organization structure is small, having the limited products. Product type. This type of the division is made according to the products. The organization divides the department based on the product. The following illustration shows the layout of the product type. Sales manager, hardware and plants manager, chemical manager, furniture and decorative manager, agro product manager. Advantage of the product type. Due attention, due to the division according to the product, each product gets required attention. Specialization, the salesperson is specialized in the specific product, hence he or she has an advantage in handling the department. Responsibility. The responsibility can be easily assigned to a salesperson because all the salesperson are specialized in their product department and are well acquainted with the product, which help them to handle customer smoothly. Disadvantage of the product type. Coordination. There would be problem of coordination between the two product department. Selling cost. The selling cost of the product may increase due to the division according to the product. Operational cost may also increase due to the each product being treated differently. Freedom. There is no cap on the freedom enjoyed by the employee because the salesperson is specialized only his product department and will not be able to handle other product department. Stability of the product type. Product type is suitable in the following cases where the organization has many products and it can be divided the department according to the product. For organization selling highly precise product. When the products of an organization are more technical oriented, the organization can divide the department according to the products as the salesperson will be efficient and effective to discuss the product with the customer in an effective way. Consumer specialization type. According to the consumer specialization, the department are divided on the basis of the customer to whom the products are offered. Most of the time, market appearance plays an important role in knowing the consumer needs and to divide the department accordingly. The following illustration shows the layout of the consumer specialization type. Sales manager, East Zone manager, West Zone manager, Central Zone manager, North Zone manager, and the South Zone manager. South Zone manager, North Zone manager, East Zone manager, Central Zone manager, North Zone manager, and the South Zone manager. Advantage of the consumer special type. Consumer, here the division is according to consumer, so each consumer gets due attention. Consumer satisfaction. Consumer satisfaction is the first priority as maximum services are provided to the consumer. Planning and policy. The sales planning is done in a proper way and policy are designed keeping each category in focus to achieve the goal. Brand. The organization is able to fulfill consumer needs and wants and create its own brand to gain the market share. Here the division is according to the consumer, so each consumer gets due attention. Disadvantage of the consumer special type. Expenses. The expenses for the company to build and plan according to consumer and develop the market are huge. sales activity, it becomes difficult for the sales manager to coordinate the sales activity of the salesperson. Investment, in this case of the specialization, the investment are high and sometimes repeated, which in turn is lost to the company. Suitability of the consumer specialization type. Consumer type is suitable in the following cases. When there is a large number of the consumers who are looking out of the special services, the customer is ready to pay for the services. Here the target is mostly premier customers. Area type. In this type of the organization, department are divided according to the attributes of the area. They can also be divided geographically. The following illustration shows the layout of the area type of the organization. Individual customer manager, individual customers, industrial customers manager, government customer manager, overseas customer manager, cooperative customer manager. Advantage of the area type. Product customer can be served with the latest product and customized product. Transportation cost. Transportation can be reduced because the division has been made according to the area. Customer service. Company can provide better customer service as the division is made according to the area. Thus, the company can understand the customer psychology and the perception better. Sales performance. The sales performance can be compared according to the zones and health can be taken to improve. Disadvantage of the area type. Costly. It is costly as compared to other types and increases expenses of the company. Market, it becomes difficult for cooperation, coordination for the general manager for the different market. There may be conflict regarding the resource allocation between the zones. Suitability of the area type. The area type of the organization is suitable in the following cases. When the area or the territory of market is very large, where the market is different based on zone, where the product is differentiated depending on zone, where the sales volume are high and generate more revenue. SDM sales quota. Sales quota can be defined as the sales target which is assigned to any sales unit for a particular duration of the time. Here, sales unit can be a person, region, distributor, etc. Sales quota provides a target to be achieved in particular duration, which increases the productivity. Commercial firms set up sales quota in order to improve sales volume and increase the net profit of the organization. It can also be viewed as a standard to determine the effectiveness of the sales unit. Sales quota is determined using various factors such as a market potential, marketing method, past sales record, etc. With effective projection of the market segment for planning sales quota, control of sales operation can be an effective method. Objective. Sales quota is imposed in an organization to fulfill the various objectives required to increase the sales of the product and maximize profit. Sales objective help an organization in the following way. They provide a standard to measure the performance. They help to control sales expenses for the customer acquisition. They help define a target. This further facilitates motivation and enhance performance. These help to identify and monitor the performance of the salesperson. There are some of the primary objective of the sales quota for organization. Further, sales quota can be divided in different types according to the requirement. Types of the sales quota. Sales quota is divided into the four different categories according to the difference in the forecasting and the cost allocation procedure. Management goals, selling issues, and the executive decision. The following are the different types of the sales quota. Sales and the volume quota. Sales and volume quota is allocation of the sales quantity for the salesperson. Geographical region and distribution outlet. This quota can be implemented according to the sales performed or revenue earned by the respective units. The combination of both the criteria can be also used for the implementation of this quota. The quantity of sales and revenue earned can be allocated to the respective unit, salesperson, region, and it has to be fulfilled at least one of them. Financial and budget quota. Financial and budget quota is used to determine and restrict expenses on sales to attain desired net profit plan. It is implemented on the various segment of the sales organization to control the expenses accordingly. The aim of this quota is restriction of the expenses for making sales so that profit can be increased. Activity quota. In competitive market, the effective performance of the sales group is required. it can act as a long term benefit for the organization. Organization set up activity quota for the sales force for efficient result. This can be performed by the allocating sales target to the salesperson. The following are the activity listed under sales quota: number of accounts opened through the salesperson, number of sale calls made to the potential customer, number of demonstration made to show the product, number of the maintenance activity performed. Activity quota is planned on the basis of these activity performed by the salesperson. By setting quota for the activity, efficient performance and controlling can be managed. Combination quota, it depends on the product type and the market condition, issue related to the sales of the product and the challenges faced during the sales of the product. Organization set up quota with combination of sales volume and activity quota in order to increase sales. Method for setting sales quota. Sales quota for any unit like salesperson, region, extra should be a reasonable and achievable goal, or it to be fulfilled at the provided time span. At the same time, quota should not be such that it does not take much effort to achieve. The following are some of the methods for setting the sales quota. Total market estimate method. Total market estimate method is used to determine the sales quota in place where the management does not have any data about the market potential. It can be determined by dividing the company's sales quota with respect to the region or dividing sales quota according to relative sales opportunity as per the region. Territory potential method. Territory potential method directly relates territorial sales potential to the sales quota. The potential here is the total industry sales for that segment. Sales potential respects the maximum market size of the product. Size of the market reflects the sales potential. This method gives precise result if the territorial sales potential are used with a combination of the territorial design. Past sales experience method. Past sales experience method determines the sales quantity based on the previous year sales. Management of the organization said this setup by increasing some percentage from the previous sales record. For more precision in the approach, management most commonly use an average of the several years as a baseline for the measurement. This method is simple and does not take much effort to implement. Executive judgment method. In this method, sales quota volume is determined by the management, but it is more likely to be a guess. The management decides the sales quantity and no fixed procedure are involved. This method is not precise and it is mostly not used by the organization to determining the sales quota. This method does not provide any estimate for the territorial based sales value. Sales people estimate method. In this method, the sales quota is determined by the salesperson of the organization. Through this approach, a more relevant sales estimate can be maintained, which can be achieved by the salesperson. Salesperson have better knowledge of the market condition, so they can set the target as per their standard. And if the standards are set by the salesperson themselves rather than imposed by the management, their fulfillment is more likely possible. Compensation plan method. Compensation method is based on the management view that a particular salesperson should receive as a revenue. This method does not take into account the sales projection or the territorial volume. For example, if a salesperson has to receive 20,000 as salary, which can be received as a 10% commission of the sales amount, then the salesperson has to sell products worth rest 2,000. SDM sales territory. A sales territory consists of a group of consumers or a geographical area assigned to a particular salesperson. The area allocated to the salesperson contains the present and the potential consumers of the organization. After the allocation of the sales territory, the sales manager can be in a position to contest between the sales effort and the sales opportunity. It would be very difficult for the sales manager to monitor the total market as it is too large and unmanageable by one person. Hence, it is divided as per territory to manage effectively and efficiently and control the sales force. The salesperson does not only pay attention to the area, but also the consumer product. Thus, a sales territory can be known as the grouping of the customers and prospect, which is assigned to an individual salesperson. Sales territory is for big company having the huge market share. Small and medium sales company don't use geographical defined territory. The market share is not so high to divide into territory. Reasons for the establishing territory. The main motive of establishing sales territory is to simplify the planning and controlling of the selling function. Following are the some reasons of the establishing sales territory. To obtain through the coverage to the market. According to the division of the sales territory, the activity are assigned to the salesperson. This helps in market coverage rather than the salesperson selling the product according to his ambition. It helps the sales manager to monitor and take updates accordingly from the different sales managers. To establish the salesperson's job and the responsibility. It is very important to establish jobs and responsibility for the salesperson. Sales territory help in doing so because the task is assigned to the salesperson and he is responsible and answerable for the same. Once the task is assigned, frequent checks are done to monitor the calls. It helps to determine the work of the each salesperson. If the sales manager finds the workload for a particular person is more, the work is divided and reassigned equally. This creates motivation and interest to work. To evaluate sales performance in an organization, the sales territory is compared from the previous years to the current, find out the difference, the increase or decrease in sales volume. It helps to work on the difference accordingly. This is done with the help of the sales territory as the active are assigned in a proper manner and gathering of data and evaluation becomes easy. The comparison to evaluate sales performance is done on the following values: individual to the district, direct to the regional, regional to the entire sales force. For this comparison, we can evaluate and determine where the sales force is contributing for high volume of the sales. To improve customer relations, as we know, salesperson have to spend most of their time on the road to sell the product, but if the sales territory is designed in a proper way, the salesperson can spend more time with the customers, present and potential. This helps in building rapport and understanding the needs better. Sales of a company can increase when a customer receives regular calls and the salesman has to visit the customer on the basis of the call. The salesman and the customer get time to understand each other and resolve their issue regarding the demand and supply. This also helps in increasing the brand value of the company. To reduce sales expenses, once the geographical area are decided, the company gets a proper picture as to the area that can be assigned to the salesperson. He or she needs to cover that area so that there is no duplication of the work by sending two salesperson in the same area. The selling cost of a company gets reduced and leads to the increase in the profit. There is also an advantage to the salesperson for the few travels and the overnight trips. To improve control of the sales force, the performance of the salesperson can be measured on the basis of the calls made to the customer, the routes taken, and the schedule. In this case, the salesperson cannot deny if the results are not positive. The salesperson has to work on the same route, schedule, and everything is predetermined. This results in better control of the sales force. To coordinate selling with the other marketing function, if the sales territory is designed properly, it helps the management to perform other marketing function as well. It is easy to perform an analysis on the basis of territory as compared to the entire market. The research done by the management on marketing on the territory basis can be used to set sales quota, expenses, and budget. The result can be satisfactory if the salesperson helps in advertising, distribution, and promotion when the work is assigned on territory basis instead of the market as a whole. Procedure for designing. At the time of designing the territory, the manager has to keep in mind the size of the territory that is going to be assigned to the salesperson. It should be neither too small nor too large. If the territory is geographically too small, the salesperson would keep calling the same customer repeatedly. In contrast, in a too large geographical area, the salesperson will not be able to reach the scattered customer as most of this time he will be utilized in traveling. Hence, the territory should not be too large or too small. It should be such that all potential customers can be visited as per the requirement. The procedure of designing sales territory is the same for all the company. We are setting the territory for the first time or revisiting the existing territory. Sales control point. As the name suggests, the management has to select a geographical control point. The control points can be classified on the basis of the district, pin code, area, states, and the city. At the time of selecting the control unit, the management should aim to select as a small control unit as possible. The following are the reasons behind the selecting some control units. Region 1, if the control unit is too large, the area with low sales potential will be hidden by the area with the high sales potential. The area with the high sales will be concealed if the area with the low sales potential will be included. Region 2, in case of any changes required in the future, they can be done smoothly. Example, a company wants to allot some territory to Mr. A. This part of the territory had earlier been assigned to Mr. B. It can be done easily as the unit is small. If the sales potential for the company is located in the urban area, the city can be used as a control point. But there are some disadvantages also, as the adjacent area to city also process sales, but they are covered by the paying additional cost to the salesperson. The control point can also be set up according to the trading area. It is a sensible decision to set the control point according to the trading area. It is based on the flow of the goods and services rather than economic boundary. The wholesaler or the retailer use trading area as the control point. Trading area can be considered as the geographical region that consists of a city and the surrounding area. This region works as the main retail or the wholesale center of the region. Generally, the customers from one trading area don't go outside the boundary to buy the goods. Even an outside customer will not enter the trading area to purchase a product. The main advantage of the trading area is that salesperson is aware of the buying habits of the customers and pattern trade. It also helps the management in planning the control. The control point can be decided on the basis of the state. A state may be capable control unit when the organization has a small sales force that is covering the market selectability. A company sells its product in the country in all the states. In this case, the territory boundary could be based on the states. It is less expensive and convenient to together get the data and making evaluation, making an account analysis. The next step after selection of the geographical control unit is to plan an audit of the each geographical unit. The reason for performing this unit is to analyze the customer prospects and find out the sales volume for each account. Account can be recognized by names. In the recent time, there are many sources to pull out the area. For example, the yellow pages, we can also collect the data through the part sales of the company. After collecting the data, next step is to estimate sales for the each geographical unit. The sales manager estimates the sales volume that the company is expected to get in the following years. There are many factors to contribute, such as a competition advantage of the company in the geographical area. Now there are many software available for calculation of the final result. This can be done much quickly as compared to when it is done by the sales manager manually. After the sales potential estimates have been taken, the system divides into the three types, which is done through the ABC analysis. This is one of the most common analysis used by the company. Where the sales potential is greater than expected, it is classified as A category. Average potential is classified as B category, and the sales potential below average is classified C category. Developing a sales personnel workload analysis. The sales personnel workload analysis is done on the basis of the time and effort taken by sales person to cover a geographical unit. The following are a few points needed to estimate workload: frequency of the call, duration of the call, travel time. The estimate workload is calculated by considering these factors. The most important factor in the duration of the call. These depend on the customers and the issue. If the problem is severe, it may take time to resolve and tackle the question from the customers. Another important factor is the travel time. This differs from one area to another area depending on the factor, transportation, condition of the road, weather condition, etc. The sales manager tries and plans according to the reduced travel time taken by the salesperson and utilize the time to call more number of the accounts and the clients. Combining geographical control unit into the sales territory. In the first these steps, the sales manager works on the geographical control unit. Now he has to combine the control unit into territory. Initially, the sales manager used to manually develop a list of territory by combining the control unit. It was a time-consuming procedure, and also the result was not accurate as it was done manually. Now computers handle this activity and complete in a much shorter period of the time, which accurate. The operational error is reduced here. All the salesperson cannot be considered equal and competitive. It depends on the basis of experience and skill. The salesperson are assigned territory by the sales manager depending on the basis of the sales. The geographical area with high sales are assigned to the salesperson with experience who can handle the workload. The new or less effective salespeople are assigned the area with the less sales potential. Territory sales shape. The sales manager has to decide the shape of the territory. The territory shape affects the selling expense or also helps for the sales coverage. There are four types of the shape which are used widely. The wedge, the circle, the hopscope, the cloverleaf. Let us discuss these types one by one. Territory shapes: wedge shape, circle shape, hopscope shape, and cloverleaf shape. The wedge shape. This shape is suitable for the territory which contain both the urban and non-urban area. The radius starts from the most populated urban center. Wedges can be divided into many sizes, and the travel time can be maintained by balancing between the calls of the urban and non-urban area. The circle, when the clients are distributed evenly throughout the area, the sales manager chooses the circle shape. The salesperson starts from the office, moves in a circle of stops until he reaches the office again. This helps the salesperson to come near to the customer as compared to the wedge. Hopscotch. In this shape, the salesperson begins from the last point from office and reach out the customer while coming back to the office. While going, the salesperson does not stop anywhere and attends call in one direction while coming back to the office. The cloverleaf. When the accounts or client are located randomly in a geographical area, the cloverleaf shape is used. This type of the shape is more of found in the industrial market than in the consumer market. Assigning sales personnel to the territory. Once the sales territory has been designed, the last step is to assign sales personnel to the territory. All the sales person are not equal in terms of the ability, initiative, etc. The workload of one sales person may be overload to another and may cause frustration. The sales manager must rank the sales persons accordingly before assignment of the territory. The ranking should be done on the basis of the ability, knowledge, communication, etc. The other point which the sales manager should look at are the cultural characteristics of the salesperson and how they match with the territory. Example, if a salesperson is born and brought up in a rural area, he would be able to do more effective sales in that particular area as compared to the urban area. We can now conclude that the goal of a sales manager is to assign the geographical area to the salesperson who would maximize the territory sales and wherein the customers are comfortable with the salesperson. Establishing the sales territory helps in planning and controlling the sales operation. A well-designed sales territory helps to increase the sales volume and the market coverage and provide better services to the customers. Once the sales territory is allocated to the salesperson, he is responsible for making this happen. Sales distribution management, personal selling. Personal selling can be termed as the oral presentation given by the salesperson to one more than one consumer face-to-face sell the product or service. Personal selling is a highly peculiar form of promotion. It is mostly two-way communication, which not only involves a particular individual, but also social behavior. The intention is to deliver the right product to the right customer, depending upon the complexity of a product. Personal selling plays an important role. Industry Manufacturing technical product like laptop, computer, digital phones, gadget, etc. likely depend on the personal selling as compared to the other manufacturer. The reason behind this is to explain the features of the product, tackle the customer query, and provide the best customer service. The competition in the market has increased today, and therefore the importance of the salesperson in the organization. Salesperson are also called salesmanson, salesman or the sales girl or sales representative, that their payment is made as commission to push the product in the market by motivating the customer through oral conversion. The consumer wants all kinds of the goods and services in the market, but lack of the interest keep them away from making decision or purchasing product. This is where the salesman need to act as a catalyst and explain the product or service to the customer. He should motivate the customer by giving a presentation, and he may sometimes act as a consultant. This helps the consumer to make a decision. In case of the technical product, the salesperson play a more vital role as compared to the promotion. It becomes difficult for the customer to make decision while purchasing high value products and complex nature. The salesperson helps the customer by making personal contact with them and making them understand and quality and utility one of the product. Objectives of the personal selling. Personal selling contributes in achieving the long-term objective for the organization. The following are the sum of the objective of the personal selling. To do the complete selling job when there are no other components in the promotional mix. To provide service to the existing customer and try to maintain contacts with the present customer. Identify and find new prospective customer. Promote and product to increase sales. Provide the information to the customer regarding the change in the product line. Provide assistance to the customer to help in the decision making. Provide technical advice to the customer for the complex products. Gather the data in relation to the market and provide it to the company management. The reason behind setting personal selling objective is to make decision on the sales policy and the personal selling strategy, which helps in promoting the products. The objectives are set for the long run at which become important element for the qualitative personal selling objective. The objective can also be quantitative if they are short term, and it could be adjusted from one promotional period to the another. The quantitative personal selling objective is related to the sales volume objective. Hence, the sales volume objective should also be explained. The following are a few sales objectives. Capture and maintain any specific market share. Increase sales volume to help the organization to gain maximum profit. Reduce or keep the expenses provided for the personal selling within the limit. Obtain the percentage of customer as per the set target. Relevant situation for the personal selling. In some situation, personal selling becomes more relevant. The following are the some relevant situation. Product situation. Product selling is more effective for the following types of the product. Product with the high value like machinery, computers, etc. Product in its first stage of the life cycle when it needs more demand. Product to match consumer needs like the insurance policy. Products that need presentation, for example, industrial product. When the products need after sales surface, product with the less brand loyalty. Market situation, personal selling can be utilized optimally depending upon the market situation and organization selling product to a small number of the buyers. Company selling in a local market. Required middlemen or agents not available. No direct channel available for the selling product. Company situation, personal selling is a comparatively more adequate to the company when a company cannot invest huge amount of money in advertisement or the regular basis. A company is unable to find and make use of the relevant non-commercial media in promoting the product. Consumer behavior situation. In case of the some consumer behavior, personal selling can be effective when the product purchased by the consumer is expensive, but it is not regular. The consumers need answers instantly without delay. The consumers need follow-up in completing pressure. These are the four situations where personal selling is important. This will help the salesperson to support the customer and provide product knowledge through face-to-face presentation. Once the customer understands the nature of the product, it helps him or her to decide whether to purchase the product. Diversity of the selling situation. in our day-to-day life, we come across different type of the selling situation. These depend on the individual selling styles because of the marketing factor. The activity of the salesperson differ as per the situation. Example, the job of a salesperson selling soft drink is different as compared to that of the salesperson selling computers. In case of the soft drink, the salesperson is not required to explain the significance or the nature of the product. But in case of the computer, the salesperson has to clarify all the technical requirement. The categorization of the salesperson is done on the basis of the selling style, creative skill required in the job, complexity of the product, etc. Let us now discuss different kind of the selling position. Delivery salesperson. As the name suggests, the job of the delivery salesperson is to deliver the product. The selling responsibility is secondary. Example, milk, curd, bread, soft drink, etc. Inside order taker. The person standing behind the counter is known as the inside order taker. He does not help the customer, which situation. The main purpose is to provide the product requested by the customer. General store. Missionary salespeople, the salesperson does not have the permission to promote an order. Their primary job is to develop goodwill and educate the customer about the product. Example, medical representative. Consultative salesperson, this type represents those products or services sold to the consumer, which are highly priced and need huge investment to the purchase. Due to high capital investment by the customer, the salesperson cannot put much pressure to sell. The salesperson should have a thorough knowledge regarding the product and the patience to discuss and advise the feature and advantage of the product. During the sales process, the salesperson has to be creative. He should maintain the interest with customer without exerting much pressure on the client. Example, huge machines, computer system, etc. Technical salesperson, the most important character of the salesperson should be the knowledge relating to the product. The salesperson should have a detailed knowledge regarding the product feature, benefit, disadvantage, etc. Most of the people don't have the required technical knowledge and easily agree to the points salesperson, but there are the few customers having the knowledge that they may influence the decision of the purchasing the product. The salesperson should satisfy this type of the customer by explaining the product feature, installation, etc. The salesperson should be well trained to tackle the question of the customer and provide relevant knowledge. Commercial salesperson. In this category, the salesperson has to sell the product to the other business, industry, or government organization, etc. It is generally businesses to the business where the salesperson closes the sale in the first or the second call. The sales process is short as compared to the business to customer sales. The salesperson has to be aggressive and highly motivated for the follow-up and the maintenance of the account. Wholesale goods, construction products, office equipment, etc. Direct sales pull. Direct sale of the product involves selling the product and services to the final consumer. The sales process is short and closed in a short period of the time. There are many products available in the market for the direct sales. Hence, the salesperson is trained to close the deal in the first visit because the consumer will either purchase the product or switch to its computer. Example, insurance, door-to-door sales, magazines, etc. Sales distribution management steps in the personal selling. The selling process consists of the several steps. There are few basic steps which need to be followed for all types of the product. The selling process can be for short time or the long time, depending on the nature of the product. A product which needs huge investment may take longer time to complete the selling process, where in case of the daily products, where the customer is aware of the nature of the product, the selling process ends in shorter time. Door-to-door sales, where the salesperson explains all the steps and ends the process in 10 to 15 minutes. However, for heavy machinery, it may take time to present the technical nature and explain the product. It takes more than one visit to complete the selling process. Prospecting. The initial step of the selling process starts with prospecting or searching for potential customer. Apart from the retail sales, it is very rare when customer reach out to the salesperson. It is salesperson who reaches out to the customer in order to sell the product. The following are two major activity under the prospecting. Find the prospect for the potential customer. Educate them in order to figure out if they are valid customers. Find the prospect for the potential customer. Finding the prospect is not an easy step for a salesperson because consumers would not even like to listen to the presentation regarding the product they don't need. The rate of saying no is very high. In few consumer goods, the identification of the customer comes from the sources like friends, relatives, colleagues, etc. The following are some of the base sources. Existing customer. One of the good sources of the prospect is an existing customer. Or a salesperson, it is very easy to sell the product to an existing customer instead of the selling of the new customer. Never-ending chain. This is a competing strategy to find out the prospect. The salesperson reaches many new customers with the help of the existing customer. The salesperson selling the product to the existing customer asks to provide referral to the friends, relative, and the salesperson reaches the new customer. This chain goes and on. Cold call. In this technique, the salesperson has to visit door-to-door sell product. The sales process starts from internal introduction, but in this case, the rejection rate is the high. Directory. The salesperson try to find out prospect customer contact with the help to the directory. The salesperson can also collect the information through the membership directory of the trade association, social organization, etc. Mailing. The company promote their product through the mails by sending advertisement. The advantage is that it is cheap and the company targets may customers by sending mass mailers. Exhibition. The salesperson who target the prospective customer through the trade show and exhibition. It is one of the simplest way and the salesperson could also practically show the use of the product and the features. Announcement in advance before the exhibition start. It is very helpful to attract more customer. Train, educate the prospects. After the salesperson has identified the potential customer, he should find out if they are valid prospect. After finding the valid prospect, the salesperson has to give the presentation. There are several approaches for qualifying customer and permanent approach is the main authority and the need. Money. The salesperson should know the financial status of the customer because money matters a lot and without it, the prospect cannot purchase the product. The consumer or the prospect should be able to pay money in return of the product. Authority. The prospect that is purchasing the product should have the authority to make decision. This is important while dealing with the government agency, corporate, etc. This is one of the most important points because if the prospect has money and also the authority, but there is no need of the product, he or she will not purchase the product. The salesperson has to find out about these aspects before proceeding to the selling process. Preparation of the sales product. Once the prospect has been identified and qualified as discussed in the first step, the salesperson has to prepare for sales of the product or service. The following are the two stages involved in preparation. Pre-approach, call planning. Pre-approach. This step involves collecting all the information important to learn about the prospect and their needs. The following are the four stops of the pre-approach. Prospect need and ability should be disclosed. All the required information which would help the salesperson to prepare the presentation. Relevant information which helps salesperson not create any inners during the presentation. Confidence to tackling the question of the prospect. Call planning. Call planning includes a particular planning sequence. The salesperson calls the customer and explains the objective of the call and explains the product to make appointment. The first objective of the salesperson is to get an order from the customer. Some objective may also required in the mid of the call progress depending on the call. Following are a few objective for the call planning. Collect more information from the customer. Find out the need of the customer and link with the features of the product. Take permission from the customer before presentation of the product. Suggest a new distributor. The salesperson has to develop a strategy and plan according to achieve the objective or goal. The salesperson should be very careful while checking the background of the customer and obtaining details. This helps to frame a strategy and develop a plan. the call made by the salesperson are costly, so they have to make prior appointment. Presentation. In this step, the salesperson has to give presentation regarding the product to the customer. He or she should explain the features of the product and how it will fulfill the needs. The presentation should be clear and understandable by the customer. It should also be interesting to keep the customer involved in the conversation. A presentation can be classified into the following category: fully automated, semi-automated, memorized, organized. Unstructured. Presentation, fully automated, semi-automated, memorized, organized, unstructured. Fully automated, in this approach, the salesperson gives presentation with the help of the slides in a structured manner. He explains and clears the doubts of the customer, example life insurance. Semi-automated, the salesperson reads out the company brochure and adds comment as per requirement for the query from the client. Example, pharmaceutical products. The company presents its message, which is short and crisp and which can be easily memorized by the customer. Organized, one of the most attractive, effective and often used approach is organized presentation. The salesperson can make changes in the presentation as required by the based on the company's predefined outline. In this approach, the salesperson covers four steps: attention, interest, desire and action. Unstructured, the salesperson and the customer together try to resolve the problem. Hence, this approach is also known as the problem solving. This type of the presentation is not well focused many times. Some points are missed and time is wasted. Also, the sales personnel has to face many queries from the customer, and if the salesperson is new in the field, he still not will be able to answer the query in an effective manner. Thus, we can conclude that the presentation to the established customer should be done by the effective salesperson. Handling objection. The salesperson has to struggle to sell the product to the customer. During the sales process, the prospect raises objection, which can be stated or hidden. Prospects may state the reason for objection and give a chance to salesperson to answer. This is an absurd situation because the prospect is informed regarding the objection. Unfortunately, in many cases, the prospect don't provide the reason for objection of the product. They hide their real reason or not buying the product. If the salesperson is unable to know the real reason, he shall not be able to resolve the problem. To resolve this, there are two techniques to find out the objection. To allow the prospect to talk, find out the hidden objection. The objection gained by the experience and mixing with the knowledge of the prospect. Many times, the objection is due to high price of the product. That objection can be answered when the salesperson has the knowledge of the competitor's products as well. Also, in many cases, the prospect don't understand the technical aspect and are misinformed. The salesperson should provide additional information in this case. Now we can conclude that the objection can be resolved by providing an alternative product to the prospect. Closing the sale. After answering the objection made by the prospect, the salesperson asks for the prospect to order the product. If the prospect does not agree to buy the product, the entire effort gets wasted. The following are some effective techniques to close and the sale. Gift close. In this technique, the customer gets an incentive for immediate buying action. The salesperson informs regarding the benefits of the product to the prospect. Example, a company provides an option to the prospect that if the bill exceeds raise 3,000. He can buy a bed sheet worth Rs. 2,000 for just Rs. 200. Hence, if the customer has made a purchase of the Rs. 2,500, he will check out to buy something else to raise 3,000. This helps the company to sell two extra products, one for the Rs. 500 or more to reach 3,000 and another bed sheet for the 200. Direct close. This is one of the simplest techniques to close the sales. This happens when the buyer has positive approach to buy a product. The salesperson summarizes the important point that were made prior to sale. Example, a prospect needs beauty cream and steps into a shop. The salesperson offers the product. If required, shows the demo. Once the prospect is satisfied, he or she will buy it. If the salesperson is experienced, he or she will try to close it as early as possible because he should understand if the prospect is inclined to buy the product. A good salesperson makes sure that he has completed all the steps during the sales process. thus closing an important step in the self process. The other steps are meaningless without the closing. Follow up. After making the sales, so the salesperson has to follow up with the prospect. After sales activity are important parts of the selling process. This helps in reducing any doubt by the customer regarding the product or services. There is also a chance that the buyer will buy again in the future. There are a specific policy by a company for after sales activity. Even though the company provides good products, there will be few complaints from the customers. The complaint should be taken seriously and the company should try to resolve. This helps the company to improve its in terms of the product or the services. An experienced salesperson try to provide the best service to its customer. As part of handling complaints, they also keep the prospect informed regarding the latest product or services and also provide other types of assistance. The salesperson should build good rapport with the customer. This helps to get more customer because the existing customer will refer to his friends and the relatives. The salesperson should thank the customer for businesses and offer small gifts. Sales distribution management, sales management budget. Sales budget is a financial plan. We show how the resources should be allocated to the achieve forecasted sales. The main purpose of the sales budget is to plan for the maximum utilization of resources and the forecast sales. The information required to prepare a sales budget comes from many sources. One of the best sources is the salesperson who deals with the product on a daily basis. The company can also gather information from the production department regarding the date of manufacture or the expiry. It is very important to forecast the accurate sales because the budget other department is based on the sales budget. For example, the production is manufactured as per the sales forecast. But if the sales forecast is not accurate, either the production will be less or more than desired. Objectives of the sale budgeting. The objective of sale budgeting is to plan for and control expenditure of resources, money, material, facility, and people necessary to achieve the desired sales objective. It aims at leveraging the maximizing profits. The purpose of the sales budget is to achieve the objective of the sales department. It also acts as a planning tool. It helps a firm to set a standard and strive to achieve them. It is also an instrument of coordination between the different departments in organization like sales, finance, production, and advertising. Sales budgeting is also a tool for control which helps by comparison with the actual result. If the actual of sale is more than the budget, we can say it is a favorable condition. Methods of the sales budgeting. There are a variety of methods which can be used to prepare a sales budget. The following are some of the popular methods to prepare a sales budget. Affordable budgeting, rule of the thumb. There is a method generally used by organizations dealing in industrial goods. Also, firms which don't give importance to budgeting or firms which are having a small size operation make use of this judgmental method. Rule of the thumb, such a given percentage of the sales, company involved in the mass selling of the goods and company dominated by the finance function are the major user of this method. Competitive method. If few company, the product of which face through the competition and may challenge in the selling, which need effective marketing strategy to maintain the profit, make use of this method. Using this method needs knowledge of how our competitor is working with regards to the resource allocation. Companies make use of a combination of the above method depending upon the past experience. Budgeting approach are refined time to time. The status of the sales and marketing helps the organization to figure out the extent of the sophistication needed in the approaching sales budgeting. Preparation of the sales budget. Preparation of sales budget is one of the most important process of the sales. Generally, companies prepare the sales budget based on the principles of the bottom of the planning. Preparation of a budget for the revenue and sales will depend on the sales organizational structure. Each department head is asked to forecast their sales volume and expansion for the coming period. For example, in a leading automobile company, the budget would be prepared district-wide as well as budget from each district would be submitted to the regional office. Clubbing of all district budget is done at the regional or the general level or DG division wise. A division budget is prepared and these divisional wise budget would vary product wise or market wise. So the division wise budget are finally submitted to the manager. Sales as either product oriented or the market group oriented. Division wise budget across all division would be submitted to the central sales department and they would scan and finalize the company sales budget. Now the marketing budget is combined with the budgets of the sales and marketing staff department, which will give a clear picture of the total sales expenses, other marketing related expenses and approximate sales revenue generated for the company. Some of the common items in each sales budget include employee salary, administrative expenses, marketing expenses, and the many more. Direct selling expenses include boarding and lodging for the salesperson, food and travel, and along with the commission or the incentive budget sales, employee benefits like the medical insurance, gratuity, and the retirement contribution, office expenses like internet charges, mailing, telephone, office supply, miscellaneous cost, advertising, and promotional materials like the selling ad, contest awards, product samples, category, price list, other miscellaneous material. Reviewing of the past sales budget helps in better planning of the future sales budget by informing about the pros and cons of the past budget. This leads to the better budget for the future and can summarize the difference between the actual and the budgeted. Communicating overall objective. It is important for the top management to present their goals and objective to the marketing department and the argue effectively for an equitable share of the fund. The chief sales executive of the firm should take the inputs from the all supervisor and managers preparing the sales budget and encourage them to come with a different idea so that after the preparation of the budget, they could take responsibility and show involvement in achieving the targets and implementing them. While preparing the sales budget, we need to set a preliminary plan so that we can allocate the resources and the efforts needed to sell the product. Increase in the customer base territory and revision in the budget can be identified in the initial sales budget so that the sales manager could provide a realistic budget with maximum efficiency. Deviation should also be identified in each stage of the development of the sales budget. As the budget is prepared by the taking inputs from the all levels of the hierarchy, the entire team would cooperate to achieve it. In case of the failure, the sales manager should have control points in order to get the budget on track. He could also include some motivational factor like rewards, public commendation, and recognition in the budget, which will motivate the employee to have a positive attitude, resulting in the achievement of the budget goals. Selling the sales budget to the top management. There should be uniformity among the budget provided by the different division. Top management of the sales and marketing would purpose and budget that anticipate the future challenge and its competitive. Along with the proposal submitted by the heads of the other division, each and every division usually demands for the additional funds and to so there could be deviation from the sales budget. These deviations should be addressed by the sales manager and they should justify each division in their budget as these would affect the profit percentage. In other words, there should be scope for the deviation as well in the sales budget. SDM, sales distribution management, marketing channel. Marketing channel can be defined as the procedure of activity that need to be performed to distribute the finished goods at the point of the production to the customer at the point of the consumption. Manufacturer use different channels to distribute the finished goods to the customer. However, the most common methods are wholesale or retail, which are discussed further. The profit is distributed between the elements of the distribution channel. So if the channel is longer, each element has lower profit margin and there is less scope for discount for the consumer. In a shorter channel, the distribution is divided between the fewer elements. Profit is higher for each element and higher discount can be provided to the customer. Wholesale. In this distribution channel, wholesaler buy the products and then distribute to the consumer. Wholesaler directly purchase goods from the manufacturer in large quantity at a discounted price. Several service tax and sale tax are reduced, which in turn reduces the cost of the final product. The wholesaler then sells the product to the consumer. From the consumer's perspective, wholesaler is a cheaper option as the cost of the product is lower than the retail value or for the wholesaler. The profit margin is higher because of the bulk purchase from the producer. Retailer, in the retailer distribution channel, the finished goods are purchased by a wholesaler or distributor. The wholesaler sells to retail shops, then the product is sold to the consumer. The wholesaler buy the product in the bulk, then the product is sold to the retailers in the lesser quantity. Further, the retail shops sell the product to the customer. Here, the distribution channel is longer than the wholesale, so the profit margin for each element is comparatively lower than the customer gets a higher cost than the wholesale. Now we discussed about the sales and distribution management.